Superhuman is one of the most talked about email apps on the market, and it is one of the most interesting with a wide combination of features. Many people don't know whether it's suitable for them or not. In today's video, I'm going to give you a full idea of whether Superhuman's right for you, breaking down some of the features in practice to see whether it is the app that you should choose for managing your email. Okay, so now we've got that out of the way, I want to start talking and showing you around the features of Superhuman. So my first feature on the list is actually keyboard shortcuts. They underpin a lot of what you can do inside of Superhuman. So here they are, and you can open up them at any time using Command K on Mac. And they are available through iOS as well. You can quickly open the command center, and to some extent, sort of feels like a quick shortcut access. Now, there are loads of different ways to access these. For example, you can clear emails using E, set reminders using H, and start emails using S. But there are a load more to learn. For example, I'm so used to snoozing emails, and that's the Remind Me feature, in which I'll then choose Remind, I put H, and then basically I'll press Enter and choose a date in the future. It could be tomorrow, it could be this week, but it's such a useful way to start organizing an email to land for later on. One other thing I really like doing inside of emails is using snippets that I've got inside of my account. Now, snippets are basically like email templates, whether that's a quick line or full emails, just to give me structure of information I'm sending to somebody, I can use snippets and create them with inside of the keyboard shortcuts area. Now, I'm always organizing emails into the split inbox, which I'll talk about later, but you can do that using shortcuts, and it's really easy to do that. Now, to be honest, once you're in an email, you can just use a keyboard to pretty much manage everything. For example, moving between emails can be pressing J, and that's just really helpful if you're looking to just browse your email without having to even touch your mouse. Although I'm not that good with it, so I'll probably end up touching my mouse at one point. So I think that's one of the best features in terms of the usability of it. It makes Superhuman feel game-like and very fast when using it. And I think there are some statistics about being slightly faster than Gmail overall in terms of its native feel on Mac or on iOS. So maybe you're looking at AI features right now. Well, Fellow is an AI meeting note transcription tool, and it's really easy to use. You plug it into your meeting, and you can turn conversations into clear, searchable meeting notes. There's even an Ask Fellow feature, which you can quickly pull up answers or action items from past meetings that you need them from. Security is in mind as well. Then they'll never train the AI on your data, and they have really great enterprise-grade features like redaction and even granular recording policies to keep your conversation safe. And finally, you can connect up popular apps like CRM tools, project management tools to help improve your team's workflows and optimize all of the action steps later. So check out Fellow below if you're interested in really taking your meetings to the next level. You can also get 10% off Fellow if you find the link in the description. So the number two feature that I quite like is the AI abilities. Now, there are a few different AI abilities, like the smart replies, AI summaries, and also just the ability to use AI to correspond and write a draft for your emails. Now, I think that my best feature of this is actually the AI summary. I sometimes come back to Threads and I want to be able to understand what's gone on. And I love reading in bullet points. So I can open up an email like this and be able to see an entire conversation that we've had going back from the start to finish in a brief summary, which is really useful. I know that many other email apps have this, but I just find it really concise the way it's structured and really helpful. Now, auto draft I sometimes use, but it is dependent on whether it's functional for you. I find that the auto reminders are a better feature. So what auto reminders does is detect inside of your emails when you've mentioned something specific, like I'll follow up next week. And then when you archive that email or press done later on, it'll come back to finding you later, which for me, I don't have to focus so much on actually corresponding and worrying about the reminders and follow-ups, although sometimes I do set reminders for them. I could just send that email and know it's gonna come back, like a bit like a boomerang. So the other thing I do like is you can use the AI feature at the bottom to draft an email, which is helpful. Sometimes I just like do certain things like just talk the email aloud on my phone, and then it basically turns it into a more concise email. which is much better. So I do like having that feature. I do wish they had the dedicated voice notes feature or something like that, but at the same time, this function does quite well. The auto drafts feature actually works pretty well. I was a bit skeptical of it beforehand because obviously you sometimes lose that tonality of an email, but actually it's quite good at getting the tone that you've corresponded in the previous emails on. So again, if you're looking for that little bit of time saver, that is helpful. So Inbox Zero, I don't think it exists anymore. Like maybe I was just really not busy before, but I don't think it exists so much. But there is something inside a superhuman called Split Inbox, which essentially takes your inbox and splits it into different sections. So I've got a few. I've got important, VIP, affiliates, and other, and then shared and calendar. There's some basics for me at the moment, but I can set up Split Inbox really easily, allowing me to get those emails into the right place. Now this makes my email inbox less bulky, and I'm in this like phase of my life where I'm trying to focus on quality, not quantity tasks. So at the same time, this Split Inbox feature is really easy to access. You can press Command K and organize any email that you're working on into that area, which is really helpful. All you have to do is allocate it, and then any future emails will come through into that area. Now the Split Inbox library is a good one as well. If you want to start choosing a few that are associated to leadership or operations or sales, then you can go and steal some in there, like document signing, for example. This is a really good feature for saving a bit of time actually setting up your own inbox splits. So the full feature, Superhuman have got a calendar feature now, and it actually works quite well as an integrated calendar with Outlook and Google. So you can connect those up and basically start booking appointments now. It works really well because it gives you smart suggestions and you can use natural language input on the right-hand side. But one thing I quite like is, say you're on an email like this, you can basically start organizing that email and send people suggested times, which is quite helpful. It does feel like part of your inbox. You can actually switch to it over on this left-hand side now, which makes you easy to create event. It essentially turns it into a full calendar app where you can actually see things that you've connected up. The thing that I sort of wish they had was a way to unify all of your emails, but you can do that by signing in to a certain inbox account each time. And naturally you can hook up additional Microsoft ones and additional Google ones as well. One thing that's quite nice is you actually move stuff around inside that calendar, which makes life a lot easier. So number five, which is sort of a bonus AI feature that I think I mentioned before, but it is a feature that allows you to auto-label items that come into your inbox. So for example, some of the basic ones that I haven't really gone into it too much, but marketing, news, pitch, and social, it detects the context of them and then brings them in the right way. And I always find that really helpful when saving time. As you can see, it has this little sort of notification. So at least you know, oh, there's pitch here. And your brain switches and goes, oh, okay, actually, I can have that mindset of replying and being a bit more correspondent. So a lot of people ask me, have you used the team abilities of this? I have not in full functionality. So that is just something to note. The team abilities allow you to share your emails with others and leave comments and correspond and even prepare a draft together, which is helpful. But there is many more details in terms of the sales functionality that you can do with that, so probably for a better video. One thing I do know is other superhuman-like apps, many people might be looking at this and going, price is too expensive, I don't like it, or not find value in it. So there are some superhuman alternatives to note. There's Shortwave, which I'll include below, Zero Mail, or Zero is being called. It's an AI prioritization inbox that is relatively new. You got Fixer. Fixer has AI meeting notes built into it as well, and I'm hearing some good stuff from it, even though it's more of a sort of a wrapper type product. Same with Jace, it's very similar in nature. Spark Mail is another good consideration, and Hey Email, built by the folks at Basecamp. Privacy First, again, for that application. So there are some alternatives to note that are on the market. Otherwise, I think Superhuman is really good if you're somebody that wants to be able to have a solid, reliable email. If you spend more than 3 hours in your inbox every single day, then I think investing in something like this, especially if you're an individual that has a budget in a company, or you're somebody that maybe spends a lot of time in email and you work for yourself, you are freelance, or you are a busy professional. One of those three categories, I think, is a good criteria for you to invest in something like Superhuman. Anyway, you can find the link below if you're interested. If you don't meet those criteria, maybe some of the other alternatives might be better for you. So thank you very much. I'll speak to you all very soon, and I'll see you all in a future video. Cheerio.